Imagine every regular viewer. When I tell you to tune in today to update the next news item telling us how everything is much worse than we expected, you thought I was kidding, right? Well, I was. It's not one news item, it's two news items. On the one hand, we have water supplies running low in England in the near future, and on the other hand, we have water supplies running low in parts of Africa right now. The jaws of death are a colloquial term referring to the point when the demand for water of a country exceeds its supply. If the current trend continues, England will hit this point within 25 years. There is a way to prolong this time span, but water use has to be cut by a third and water leakage by half. The exact words of Sir James Bevan, chief executive of the UK Environment Agency, are, "Around 25 years from now, when those demand and supply lines cross, is known by some as the jaws of death. The point at which we will not have enough water to supply our needs, unless we take action to change things. This action should be taking the form of reducing water demand. We need water wastage to be as socially unacceptable as blowing smoke in the face of a baby or throwing your plastic bags into the sea." Finally, Bevan was not shy of expressing the reason for why water supply will go down. Water companies all identify the same thing as the biggest operating risk: climate change. This development does not just pose dangers to humans. By 2040, rivers will potentially carry 50 to 80% less water, which will have a giant impact on nature too. While these are developments in the near future for Europe, they are already reality in a lot of places. Over 2 billion people already live in countries experiencing high water stress, and global water demand will grow by up to 30% by 2050. Water is already rationed in cities in Zimbabwe and Mozambique. Water shortages were narrowly averted in Cape Town, while emergency supplies had to be used in Bouake, Ivory Coast. In general, sorry if I mispronounce names of cities or persons. Not all these water shortages are only due to climate change, though. Accra, Ghana, is located in a zone with a lot of rain, but still faces shortages, mainly due to insufficient infrastructure. In general, the infrastructure has to be expanded by a lot throughout Africa if humanitarian crises are to be averted. The African Development Bank estimates that Africa needs to spend around $130 billion in infrastructure, but currently lacks 68 to 108 of those billions. Private investors are unlikely to chip in because these projects, while important for the well-being of the African societies, are not necessarily profitable.
Seeing how people don't really tend to stay where there is no water to support them, how the European Union was already completely overwhelmed by the last refugee crisis, and how this last refugee crisis is only a shadow of what is to come once large-scale water scarcity really kicks in Africa, it might actually be more economical to just give those $108 billion, let's say, as a credit to the African nations at a very low or even no rate of interest. Apart from that, there is not too much to say about this. It makes me sad, but news items like this will only come again and again and again. And, well, that's only the damn... Those are only the first little shadows of what is to come. It will get really, really ugly. And the only thing we can control right now is how much more ugly we allow it to get. And with each day that passes, it will get more ugly. Furthermore, there are only a few ways to actually increase water supply. I'm no expert at this, but maybe once we have available a source of energy that makes energy really, really cheap, like for instance nuclear fusion, we could use that in order to clean the water in the oceans. That might be a possibility, but apart from that, there's not really much one can do to obtain more water in a way that doesn't damage the environment even further, and therefore over time decreases the water supply even more. So this is going to be a problem. This is going to be a big, big problem.